Hello, good morning, dear students. No, so how are you this morning? Another busy week, no, wherein we cannot have our face-to-face classes because of the conflict in schedule in our school. No, and therefore I had made this initiative to have the recordings for your consumption. So kindly find secure connectivity, you know, so that you can watch this lecture video, you know, so you can go to the library, you know, or you can watch it in groups or in pairs, you know, so that you can share it to your classmate if your classmate doesn't have the gadget or the data for this particular lecture. Now, so we will now proceed with lesson two in our discussions for CRPH readings in Philippine history. I do hope that you were able to watch the lesson one discussion, very brief, that I had last week. And I do hope that majority of you had already complied to our written test two, which is the history of or the Filipino historians, you know, their background and their contributions to the historical narrative. So this morning, I'm going to discuss to you lesson two already. No. Okay. Okay, so here we go. So lesson two is about the history and the historian. No, so who are the historian? Who is the historian and how do historians contribute, no, to the development or to the evolution of history through time? No, so if you had made your assignments, no, if you had conducted your mini research already, so you will already have a background, no, of who is a historian and what particular contributions, no, does the historian do, no, in our historical narrative. No? So our first discussion will focus on who is a historian, no? Sino ba ang sino ba ang maituturing na, or ano ba ang maituturing na isang historiador, no, or historian. So a historian is someone who is the primary responsible for the production of historical knowledge, no? They are the ones who produce the historical knowledge, and these are the knowledge that we read, no, in textbooks. These are the knowledge that we hear from our teachers, from our instructors. These are the historical knowledge that is portrayed, no, in televisions and in movies. So who are the primary sources, no, or who are the responsible in the production and in the dissemination of this historical information or historical knowledge? These are the historians, no? So they produce historical knowledge through continuous research, no? So one aspect, no, going back to lesson one, one component, one dimension of history is that it is an academic discipline, no? It's an academic discipline which observes methods and methodology in order to discover facts and knowledge about the history. No, so it's a continuous research and rethinking of history. History is not fixed, by the way. No, what is history? What is an accepted history today can be a different history tomorrow or in the future, depending on the evidences evidences that will surface or new evidences that can be found by historians, no? Yung mga historical facts, no, that we are accepting nowadays, these are facts because there is an existing evidence that provides them that they are facts, no? But we are not yet sure, no, na down the line or sometime in the future, no, new evidence or new studies will surface that will prove, no, na these are only partly true or these are totally false, and that new aspects or new facts of history can be discovered. So when we talk about history, it's a continuously evolving discipline. No, it's a continuously evolving narrative that is based on the evidences, no, that is constantly being discovered, questions that are constantly being asked by the historians. No, they ask questions and they try to answer them through evidence and through sources. No, so that is the main definition, no, that is the main description of who is a historian. Okay, so who qualifies as a historian? No, so na-describe na natin kung ano ba ang historian. So ano ba yung mga qualification? Ano ba yung mga panuntunan para masabi natin na okay, ito ay isang certified na historian? No, so it's very important to know the qualities or the qualifications of who is a historian, no? Because it's important that we know that the historian has the training, we know that the historian has the experience, we know that that historian has a background, because hindi basta-basta maging historian, no? You're going to provide information, no, you're going to provide information that can either help people, lead people, or if you are not a qualified historian, you might mislead people, no? And this had already happened in the past, no, na some historians, they are going to present pieces of information, no, fact, historical knowledge, no, and they are not fully scrutinized, they are not fully analyzed, and it had misled people who had read those findings, no, or had read those historical facts. And therefore, it's really important, no, na marunong tayong mag-scrutinize, no, kung ano ba dapat ang qualification, sino ba dapat, ano ba dapat meron ng isang historian para masabi natin siya ay isang historian, at para masabi natin na meron siyang credibility. Ayon, siguro that's the key word here. No, why we are examining the qualifications of a historian. So that historian, whatever the claim, no, kung ano man yung sasabihin niya, meron siyang credibility. No, because he or she has the qualifications to do so. So sino, what are the qualities or who qualifies as a historian? Number one is, pinaka-importante, a historian is someone who is academically qualified. Ibig sabihin, para masabing ikaw ay isang historian, para masabi na ang iyong mga sinasabi or ang iyong kinukwento sa mga tao ay kasaysayan, no? You should be someone who is academically qualified. Pag sinabi natin academic qualified, ibig sabihin talagang nag-aral ka, no? Meron talagang kurso na AB history, no? Arts, Bachelor of Arts in History. And kapag nag-aral ka ng AB in history, no, papag-aralan mo talaga yung scientific process, no, you're going to learn the different philosophies, no, the different procedures, no, the different methodologies on how you're going to come up or to conclude historical facts, no. So may 4-year course talaga yan, no. So if you are someone or kapag ang isang tao ay nagsabi siya na he knows history, or someone na na nagsasabi na alam ko ang kasaysayan, no, but hindi siya nag-aral, no, wala siyang proper na training, no, then it's difficult to believe that person. It's difficult to put credibility in that person, no. So ang pagiging historian, no, kagaya ng pagiging doktor, no, kagaya ng pagiging abogado, no, meron yang kurso, no, meron yang kurso silang pinag-aaralan, no, para malaman nila yung proper process, no, proper process ng pag-conduct ng historical research and pag-produce ng historical knowledge. Number two is, a historian is someone who is professional. No? So, syempre, if you have studied about history, no? If you have conducted lots of research, lots of reading, no? Definitely. No? And if you are, I don't know if there's a license to be an historian or there's an experience. No? So, definitely you will become a professional historian. And usually, no, yung legitimate historians, they are the ones who is associated to historical organizations. No, meron silang mga organizations that they are a member of. No, and that is one proof. No, that is one evidence that yung tao na yun ay talagang historian because he is acknowledged by an organization of historians na siya ay isang historiador, no? So that's why I think in some of those who submitted their Filipino historian, some of you had indicated na this historian is a member of this particular organization. He is the chairman or he is the president of this historical society, so and so. So those are some of the components, no? Those are some of the qualities that historian is a legitimate historian because he's a member of a professional historical organization. Second is, a true historian is someone who is doing history as a full-time career, no? Talagang trabaho niya talaga yung maging historian, no? He is a historian by profession, no? He earns his majority of his living by conducting historical studies. Although some of these historians, they are full-time historian, but some of them are part-time teachers, no? Part-time teachers, no? They are part-time journalists, no? So they are also part-time TV personalities if they have shows, but their full career or their full work should be a historian. Yun talaga yung totoong historian. No, anybody cannot be classified as a historian kung part-time lang niya siyang ginagawa, no? Kailangan full-time talaga siya na historian. A historian is someone who continues to pursue historical knowledge, no? Usually yung totoong historian sila yung mga taong mahirap makontento, no? Mahirap silang makontento sa ganitong kasagutan, sa ganitong kasaysayan, no? They are always curious, no? They are always asking for more details. They're always asking for more questions, no? That's why na, if you can remember, no? If you're able to remember our first activity, yung history or chismis, I've actually started checking your papers, no? That's why I've asked you, tinanong ko kayo, ano pa ba yung gusto ninyong malaman sa taong ito? No, and marami sa inyo nagsabi na wala na akong gustong malaman. That's not an historian mindset. No. Hindi iyan mindset ng isang historian or someone who is a scientist or has a scientific curiosity. No, ang isang historian ay hindi nakokontento sa kung ano yung sinabi sa kanya. There's always questions. There's always more questions about it. No, that's why nga ginsiro na ako ng mga naghambang ako gustong pangutanon ka. No, dapat may imo gida. No, may kasi abo pa tayo moro niya story. No, bisan di man na ikaw pag subton, but there should be questions na dapat imong pangutanon. At kung di man na pag subton ay, that's why nga gin-ask ko kamo. No, if you can recall nga, paano pa ninyo masairan or how will you validate pa in other sources na kung hindi man nanaki nyo hambagon, hay, pwede man ninyo masairan, no, sa ibang pamaagi, no? Like, I think some of you had mentioned na looking into the written records, no, birth certificate, no, diary or other na mga report cards, no, oral evidence, no, asking family members, asking friends, no. So these are the real historians, no. Real historians are not content, no, with what is given or what is present, no. They always challenge themselves, they always challenge their historical knowledge, and they always find possible evidence that will contradict or will further support the historical claim made. Okay, so kung gusto niyo magkaroon ng historical na ano, na historical na mahitis, you always ask question. No, wag kayong makontento, no, sa bawat sagot, no. You always ask question para malaman ninyo if yung sinasabi ay totoo or baka nagsisinungaling sa inyo. Okay, so that's the historian, no, analyzing and answering, no, kasi every day or every few years there's always new evidence being discovered, new written material being discovered, new archaeological evidences, no, may mga nahukay na mga bungo at kalansay, may mga bagong nahukay na mga banga, no, or mga evidence sa ganitong lugar. So that's another evidence, that's another layer of evidence that can alter, no, that can alter the current historical narrative, no. So we shouldn't be content of the historical narrative that we have, because it's like what I've said, history is always evolving, it's always changing. Okay, so that qualifies a historian. So what are the tasks of historians? So ano ba yung mga trabaho? Ano ba yung mga trabaho ng mga historian? So number one is to convert historical sources to historical knowledge, no? Hindi lahat ng evidence doesn't speak for itself, no? Like for example, ang isang kapirasong pottery, no? For example, may nahukay na basag na panga sa likod ng bahay, no, ng isang particular na tao. So sa ordinaryong tao, banga lang 'yan, no? Sa ordinaryong tao, pottery lang 'yan, no? But in the training, no, or in the analysis of a particular person, no, hindi lang 'yan basta banga, no? That it isn't just a piece of pottery, no? That can mean so much, no? This pottery can be evidence na meron diyang settlement before, no, meron diyang palengke, no? This evidence can be na itong pottery na ito, for example, is from China, no? For example, so that's an evidence already na meron diyang trade between Filipinos and Chinese, no, in the ancient past, no, and so many things pa, no. So kung isang particular lang siya na evidence, no, isang particular lang siyang document to an ordinary person, it doesn't really mean anything, no. The evidence or the sources, no, taken as it is, no, mababaw lang yung pag-intindi ng normal na tao or yung tao na walang historical background, no. But because of the work of historians, because of the training of historians, no, they were able to contextualize this evidence, no. They were able to help us comprehend kung ano yung mas malalim na importansya noong kapirasong banga na yon o noong kapirasong kaang na yon na nakita doon sa likod ng bahay, no. So that's the majority, or that is the primary work of historians, no, to make evidence talk to us, to extract the historical knowledge from this evidence and help us digest, no, kumbaga, hay, ng mga historic, mga historians nga rahay, sandaro digestive system, no? They digest this raw evidence, they digest for us this raw information, no? Ag sandaro gabuo it mga ano, mga facts, sandaro gabuo it mga sustansya ag nutrition sa mga evidence nga, so that pag-abot katon hay magupta nyo naton niya, ah okay, daya galing nga lang apat nga rahay, naghaling galing mo sa China, ah okay, dayang pat galing nga rahay, evidence galing mo ra, nga rikaragali hay may dati nga trade route or trade route it mga Pilipino at mga Chinese, no? So pag-abot katon hay na ano na imo na transcribe na imo na translate na imo sa historical narrative, bukon yun imo it kapiraso ng kaang or kapiraso ng banga. Second is to determine what is historical fact, no? So again hay, although history is the study of past events, take note na hindi lahat ng mga nangyari sa nakaraan ay makasaysayan, no? So like for example, ikaw nag-birthday ka noong 10 years old mo, or for example nanalo ikaw ng Miss Hinampang last year, no? So those are events happening in the past, no? But not all of these events are historical, no, in terms of its impact and its significance, no, in the historical narrative of the Philippines, of Filipinos, or of specific or important event in our history. No, so it is the job of the historians, no, sila yung nag-identify ano yung mga events na nangyari na talagang mahalaga lang talaga, no, mahalaga in terms of mas maunawaan, no, ang kasaysayan, no, mas maunawaan ang mga kaganapan sa kasalukuyan, no. So that's it. So that's the job of the historians. Okay, to identify what is historical fact and what is not historical fact. The third task of the historians is to provide historical explanations. Ayun. So yung trabaho nila is maghanap ng causal explanation. No? For example, causal explanation to contemporary issues and problems. Now, for example, we're going to ask, no, na bakit ba may kahirapan sa Pilipinas? Or for example, another sensitive issue also, na bakit ba ang hirap tanggapin ng mga Pilipino ang LGBT community? No? So the historians, no, will try to explain these current issues by going back to the history. No, by going back to the historical events, no, in our country or in our history, that will try to explain, no, bakit meron tayong mga attitudes na ganito, no? Perhaps we can go back to the history na being the Philippines, no, being a Catholic country or predominantly Christian country, no? So being ingrained, no, being conservative, no, being ingrained for so many hundred years, no, so that can be an explanation, no. Poverty in the Philippines, no, you can always go back to the history of how struggles between the oligarchs, no, yung mga rich families, no, controlling all the major corporations, no. We can always go back to corrupt government leaders, no, na nag-contribute sa hindi pag-unlad ng kanilang particular na probinsya o ng particular na rehiyon or bansa, no. So there are historical explanations in the past that can answer our current problems that we are experiencing nowadays. So trabaho yan ng ating historians, to go back in history and try to provide us with explanations. And through these explanations, hopefully we can derive solutions to it. Okay, so those are the tasks of our historians. Nine, I question, we now discuss the issue of objectivity of the historian. No? So pagdating sa history, no, pagsusulat ng kasaysayan, no? Kasaysayan and doing the historical narrative. There is what we call the bias or the subjectivity. No, so according to our reference, no, bias or subjectivity, this is a disposition brought together by one's context that influences historians' historical interest and selection of sources and methodology. No, so yung mga historians natin, ang mga historiador, sila rin ay mga tao. No, and bilang mga tao, mayroon silang mga biases, no, may mga subjectivity sila, no, so ibig sabihin na may mga prejudice sila, may mga, how do I say it, may mga pinapaboran sila, may mga favorite, ayun, siguro mas magandang term for that is when you talk about bias and subjectivity, there is what we call the favoritism. No, so for instance, if the historian is a female historian, most likely yung bias ng tao na yon, no, would be focusing on subjects, focusing on person in history, specifically na babae, no, because he is a female historian. No? So most probably she will be biased to female persons, no? Female or events in history na predominantly made by or moved by females, no? So that is a bias or subjective. Ano pa ba? Kung ang particular na tao ay, for example, Ilocano, if the historian is Ilocano, no, then most likely magiging bias siya sa Ilocano history, no, ibig sabihin yung magiging focus niya, no, ay anything about historian, anything about Ilocano, no, historical interest, no, definitely, no, if focus lang niya kung saan siya lumaki, kung saan ba yung familiar siya, and of course to analyze it based on sa kanyang perspective bilang isang Ilocano, perspective niya bilang isang tao, kung ano yung kanyang mga philosophies in life. No? So, there is what we call the bias and subjectivity. No? Kumbaga may favoritism. No? So, same thing also, no? Na for example, if a particular historian, kapag ang historian na ito ay, let's say, victim siya ng martial law, no, so magiging bias siya about martial law, no, definitely ang kanyang magiging tone ay most probably magiging against martial law siya, against Marcos siya, no, probably, no, just because may experience siya na siya ay victim, no, so may bias siya being a victim of martial law. Mahirap naman na maging objective, no, mahirap maging patas sa isang issue na yan kung ikaw mismo ay may mga ano ka, may mga subjectivities ka, no, may mga biases ka, may like at may dislike, no, or in our case may dislike siya sa martial law. No, yung kanina, no, like, no, kasi siya ay Ilocano, most likely magiging bias siya sa Ilocano. Yung isa naman, no, victim siya, so may dislike siya sa martial law or sa Marcos era. So probably, no, there's a tendency na since he or she is a victim of martial law, probably he will be focusing more on the negative part of the Marcos administration and not so much on the positive aspect of it, or at least a balanced perspective. Yan ang tinatawag natin na bias. No, na ano pa ba? When we say bias, siguro magandang balikan yung example natin doon sa history at chismis, no? If you can remember na in-interview ninyo yung kaklase ninyo, there is a bias there, no? There is a bias dun sa pagkukwento ng kaklase niyo, no? Bias in a way na pinili lang niya kung ano yung mga ikikwento niya sa iyo. No? That's the number one bias, no? Bias subjective niya na as a historian, no? As a historian, as a personal historian ng kanyang talang buhay, she is biased in terms of selecting only the events that he or she is going to tell you. So selective, what parts of history, what parts of her or his history nga maga-focus imaw. And then bias man imo sa pag-interpret itatong mga events. No, nga hambaw na nga ay mga events nga ra positive raya nga ra hay mga manami nga events. No, ag syempre bias kagay lang, kumbaga hindi ka man mag-istorya it something nga bulok imo, di ba? Di ka man mag-istorya it something nga ikayain imo. So may mga makaron man niya aspeto sa mga historian. No, because again, historians are also human beings. They are also self-protective, no, of themselves. They're also self-protective of the groups, the people, or the society that they belong to. They're protective of women. They are protective of Ilocanos, Ilonggos, Aquianos. They are protective of their status. No, pinaprotektahan nila yung mga mayayaman. Pinaprotektahan nila yung mga aktivista. No, so they are also protective of ano pa ba? Their personality, their beliefs. Ayun, that's also another bias, no? It's another source of bias, no? Bias of whether you are a Christian or probably a Muslim or some kind of other faith. That's also a form of bias, no? So these things intermingle, no? These things influence a historian in terms of how does he or she produce historical knowledge, how does he or she collect sources and interpret the sources to become historical knowledge. So, ito na yung tanong natin. So, kung yung historian ay bias, no, kasi, and we are really acknowledge naman na may bias. So, kung ang historian ba ay bias, is there any possibility na we can arrive to a objective historical truth? No, can we really see an objective historical fact? No, can we have that objective truth na walang kulay, no, na walang halong politika, or walang, sabi nga dun sa isang famous line, walang kinikilingan, walang pinoprotektahan? Can we really have that type of historical knowledge, no? If there is what we call the issue of bias and subjectivity, no? So the answer is yes. No? Yes pa din. It still can. No? Although hindi natin masasabi na 100% objective because that's impossible. No? Impossible talaga na maging 100% objective. But yes, it is still possible that it can be predominantly objective, no? Because again, history is a scientific inquiry. No, there is a methodological process. No, there is rules. There is technique. No, and if the historian, no, if the historian follows that strict rules and techniques sa pag-collect niya ng evidence, sa pag-examine at pag-interpret niya ng data, then definitely hindi makukulayan yung knowledge or yung historical information na mapoproduce niya through his or her historical knowledge. No, so yun lang, that's the secret to it, no, para maiwasan natin na maging bias, no, in everything that we say. We have to follow the rules and techniques. No, kailangan meron tayong procedure, meron tayong panuntunan na susundin, no, para hindi tayo magiging defensive, no. So that's why nga sabi ko nga, you have to have the questioning mind, no. Dapat pa, lagi kayo nagtatanong. You're going to ask that person, no? Going to that part of ano tawag dito, history or chismis, no? Kung papabayaan nyo lang yung tao na magkwento, sige, kwento ka lang, no? Then magiging bias talaga siya. Nagkukwentuhin niya lang kung ano yung gusto niya, Pakwentuhin niya lang siguro kung ano yung maganda sa kanya, no? Pakwentuhan niya, kwentuhan ka lang niya kung ano yung gusto niyang marinig mo. Because that's what you call the bias or self-subjectivity. But if you're going to apply rules and techniques, no, magtatanong ka, magiging strict ka sa iyong tanong, magiging specific ka sa iyong mga tanong. No. For example, si strictuhan mo siya na yes or no lang or rate or ano, i-rate mo gaano kadalas or gaano kadalang, for example, no? So if you're going to use rules and techniques, then you can objectively collect and examine your data. Same thing also, no? Another example also is your historical birthday. No, na I am really competent or I'm really confident na napakaraming kaganapan na nangyari sa inyong birthday, no? Hindi lang yung tatlo na yun. Pero bakit yun yung tatlong pinili ninyo? Because you have bias. No? You have bias for that three events. Merong something sa inyo. No? Merong something personal sa inyo na nagtulak sa inyo na pumili kung bakit yun lang yung mga kasaysayan na in-include doon sa inyong activity. No? And because of that, that is what you call the bias. Ano pa ba? Evidence or interpretations put forward by a historian, even though that they are biased, can still be validated with other sources. So, kahit na may mga bias na mga historical knowledge, no? Marami ang nagsasabi ngayon na marami daw ang mga historically distorted or ano pa ba yung masasabi natin na historical fake news. Historical fake news. Kung meron mang mga historical fake news, no, there are things that we can do in order to validate or in order to prove whether they are true, whether they are history, or whether they are chismes. Because there are other sources pa of evidence, no? We can validate it using other sources, no? And this will be discussed in our next lesson, no? The primary and the secondary sources, no? So that's why I have asked you again, no? I have asked you doon sa inyong history or chismis na paano mo ngayon mapapatunayan? Kasi sinabi niya lang sa iyo, eh. Sinabi niya lang sa iyo. So paano mo mapatunayan na totoo yung sinabi niya? Oh, nilagyan ko ng zero yung mga nagsabi na eh kasi naniwala ako sa kanya, nakita ko siyang umiyak. That's not enough. No, hindi mo pwede yung bigyan ng weight. No. To be a historian, no, to be someone who nga hindi ka kasi abo man yung mga budol-budol nga makan, take note ha. No, take note. Abo man nga mga budol-budol, abo nga mga estapador, dumayad magtangis. Abo ro mga estapador nga mayad mag eye contact inyo di inyo masayran kung gapino real sanda ina practice manandara, no? So that's why nga, hindi ka mo basta-basta magpatiagi nga porke nga nakita niyo sa lang mata nagtangis gid imaw. No, the mind of a historian should be always validate it using other sources, no? Usoy ka mo it other nga written record, no? Usoy kong anak-anak ko nung pangalan ay si Andres Bonifacio. Agto ka ito sa PSA. Tanaw mo ka sa PSA kung exist gid man si Andres Bonifacio nga ron nga haraan ng edad ang harang lugar. Agto ka sa COMELEC. Pangatanong mo sa COMELEC kung may nakarehistro ba nga raya nga ra nga botante imaw, rehistro, exist ba nga raya nga ra. Agto ka sa NBI. Anawon mo kung may criminal record. Haron talaga ro, ano, validation of evidence. Anawon mo lagi mo kung may anang record, it criminal. No? O naghamba may nagpakilala kay mo, single ko no imaw, mapati ka lagi. Mapati ka lagi nga single imaw. Oh, no? Ginchat ka lang nana, it ayam nga mau makaron applying flying kiss eh. In love kagagi. Pangatanay mo kung may nubiya ima or may asawa nagpati kagagi. That's not the mindset of a historian. No, hindi ka magpati kagagi. Double check. Tanawa ro ana nga Facebook account. Pero sa bagay, abuo na makaroon ng mga nag-operate ibang account. So, pangatanan mo ang pinatawa niya pangalan. Tanawan mo sa PSA. Double check mo kung may anang ano, kung may kung married ima or bukon. Mga makaroon ba ga? No, gina-validate natin sa other sources, no, written sources. At sa bilog pa, no, naila ko sa mga nagsabat it, triangulation, no. You're going to validate it sa anang mga pamilya, no, sa anang parents, sa anang mga family, no. Kung minatogil mat ang single baga imaw, no, validate ni mo kung wagin man imot unga, wagin man imot asawa, bukong gid man baga imot kasal. No, so that's another option, no, you can do to validate any historical knowledge, no, or any knowledge nga ano. So makaron man do ginobra it mga historians, no, kung ano man do mga gina-claim it other historian or gina-claim it other nga at ibang tao ay gina-validate nanda ron sa mga sources, gina-validate nanda sa mga ebidensya, whether it's written, whether it's a testimony of other people, no. So that's how it is done. Ang pangatlo, no. So haron ha, haron do daywa, haron yung do daywa. Daywa nga pamaagi, no. Paano nato mas ma-objective, ma-objectify para paano mabuhinan do bias sa pag-report it history. No, pangatlo ay gina-confirm, no. It has to be confirmed by other historians, no. So bukod yang it pag sinambag isang bilog na historian niya, ay siyo siya Rizal ay agi or gay, for example. Ay, pukuntar, dito ang pagbatunon niya agiron, no, or gay, or for example, ay anti-Catholic, no, for instance. Ay, hindi aron, porke nga ginhambad sa bilog na historian, ay batunon niya agi buong kalibutan or buong Pilipinas nga, as siyo siya Rizal ay gay, or LGBT, or imaw ay anti-Catholic. No, just because nasa bilog na historian naghambay, does it mean niya automatic historical fact immoral. It will be validated pa. No, may iba karon niya historians nga andang i-double check, andang balikan do kung paano mo nag-imbestiga sa ro yun, paano mo nag-come up sa ro niya conclusion niya si Rizal Gali ay makara-makara. So, it will be peer-reviewed. No, it will be validated by the other experts also, no, with similar or higher expertise than the original historian niya nag-claim or nag-propose it historical knowledge, no. So when we talk about history, when we talk about historical fact, no, we can be certain, no, nga bukod basta-basta kita nga giinobra, no, giinobra kita, ga-interpret kita, ga-imagine kita at mga historical facts or ga-infer kita, nagahula-hula kita, no. No, because again, going back to our lesson one discussion, history is a scientific inquiry. It's a scientific process. May ginasundan ang mga pag-analyze step by step, mabusisi, maurirat, no, ang ginapilapat aron niya balik-balik bilang back and forth sa pag-analyze it evidence, pag-consult sa iba't ibang tao, sa iba't ibang expert. Kung maubraon doon nanda, then that's the time that you're going to formulate a particular historical fact, or they're going to alter the historical narrative based on that historical evidence. Okay, so here is the reference, no, for our discussion for lesson 2, the history and the historian. So written test 3, Filipino historian, no. Hopefully everyone had already submitted their outputs. I had started reading some of them, and I don't know yung iba, no. Some of them are copy paste, no. So I will give you an opportunity to revise your work, no. So kindly practice paraphrasing your work, no. Improve your presentation, no. Bukod mag copy paste yang kamo, no. So when you do your work, you get your idea and incorporate also your insights. Some of the outputs, no, that were submitted, I'm not also sure kung tanan dato hay historians, no, machari iba tay machabukwan dat historian. Please make sure, ha, double check with other sources. Base iri iba kinyo hay sambilog at other sources nga ginbuan, no, nag site ka, nag-usoy ka mo sa Google, hay ginhambal iri kato sa sambilog nga site hay historian imaw, di ka mo magpati, no. You have to double check in at least pag internet doon, dapat 5 sources. Oh, remind ha, sa internet, at least 5 sources, 5 websites na naghambal nga imaw, hay historian doon imaw. No, haron dapat, buko niyang itsambilo. No? So, please double check ha, inyong mga ginapasa, gina-double check ko ron imaw. No? Ay, base masiro ka mo, buko at historian inyong insubmit ka ko niya ron. Please double check. No? And also include in your concept diagram or in your picture diagram the interests. No, ano ba rong mga interests at ano rong mga contributions ito inyo mga historians. Bukon it anda lang gid niya background. Yo, pinakaimportante sa mga historians nga rahay kung ano ro andang mga ano ro part it history naging contribute. What part of the historical knowledge to naging contribute sa ato niya historical narrative, no? Did they focus more on the war era? Did they focus more on the prehistoric history of Filipinos? So haron ako niya gusto ninyo, gusto na akong i-focus ninyo kung ano ra nang naging tutukan, no? Ano na mga books naging publish about alin do mga books nga ra? Haron tara akong gustong makita sa inyo nga conceptual or picture diagram of Filipino historians. Underneath this video also, ikara sa website nga, I'm also going to introduce to you one of my idol Filipino historian, no. Actually, hay naging professor gid na ako ni Imaw, no, sa way back in college. He's a full historian. He's a really a professional historian, but at the same time he is also a teacher, no, teacher namo ni Mao sa college ag kadugo-dugo gid aro ana nga subject na history, no. Hatoro history class nga day 1 pa lang namon ay may 1 to 100 akin nga exam about history, no. Pero masadya, no, masadya because aboro ako niya appreciation about history, no. Ana nga ana kato nga focus it history hay nag-focus imo sa Katipunan Revolution as well as American Revolution, Japanese occupation sa Manila, no, sa Manila. Ano rong mga nagkatabo sa Manila during the revolution, the Japanese occupation, no? Imaw hay si Sir Bernard Carganilla. No? Si Bernard Carganilla. So, may video ako iyang i-upload at the bottom of this, or I am going to upload one of the video. Makita ninyo kung sino raya nga rang contemporary Filipino historian, makita ninyo how do historians work and how do historians perpetuate historical knowledge. Okay, so that's my Filipino historian also. Okay, so written test 4. Oh, ayan na, dami niyang trabaho, ah. Oh, maala ka mo. Written test 4 is about primary sources, no? So this will be our topic next meeting. So in advance, I'm going to give you this activity agad may idea ka mo. So simply malang, you're going to visit the FB page of Ro Aklanon, no? Here is the link. I'm going to provide also the link para sa ato niya instructional page, no? So just visit the Ro Aklanon niya Facebook page. Look for one primary historical source. Sambilog ang news clipping about Aklan or the Ati-Atihan. Iyabi sa Facebook page nga rahay, anda bang in picturean do mga newspaper, mga pictures it about Aklan or the Ati-Atihan kat kinatokato katabaga 1970s, 1950s. So mga primary sources kitaraya nga rahay nga ginobra during that time, no? So gusto ko nga i-appreciate ninyo, no? I-appreciate ninyo kung ano rin itsura it aklan or kalibo during that time, no? So screenshot ka mo, pilihan ka mo kung siin karon sa rinya-rinya mga pictures na available sa FB page through Aklano, no? Screenshot your selected primary source and then answer the following questions, no? So hamat daya imong pinili, ano ro nag-interest kim, hamat pinili ni mo raya nga rang primary source, ano ro imo, hamat nakarelate ka sa raya nga rang material source. And then, hi, reflect, no? What is your external criticism? Ano imong external criticism sa raya nga rang source? No? Authenticity. Authenticity of the sources as well as your internal criticism, no? The content, authenticity of this content, no? So for an in-depth explanation of external criticism and internal criticism, may una ra sa ato niya, lesson 3, no? So you can read in advance. Okay, so that's it, no? So I think that wraps up our discussion, no? Almost 1 hour man ato niya discussion. So I do hope that mas klaro un kato, no? I'm really hoping na mas klaro un kato do. Sino ro historian? Ano ro anang trabaho bilang historian? Ano ro anang proseso ang ginaagian, no? Para makaproduce ima with historical knowledge. Paano na makontrol or paano naton ma paano na na ma makontrol do mga biases nana or paano naton ma-validate, no? Paano naton ma-reduce, mabuhinan do mga biases it mga historian ag ma-ensure naton nga tama ra yang arang mga ginahambag it mga historians nara based sa evidence nga available katon, no? So I do hope nga medyo nagubtan naton, no? I know nga medyo malisod kita mo ra yang topic nara, even though magbasa kita sa libro malisod, but I'm really trying my very best, no, to really simplify it for you and to make it more easier to digest and easier to appreciate, no? That's why haraman daw ako niya na appreciate, no, kung sayang nga rang recording nga rang, because mas nakakaisip ako, no, mas malinong at mas mahipo, so mas abo ako niya mas ma-explain ko mo properly, no? Kasi kung sa classroom abi hay with all the factors, no, of sangag, lingaw, init and also kalisod. So I'm expecting you to try to read watch this video, read the book, and then sa ato niya face-to-face classes we will have our assessment, we will have our oral recitation, and if you have questions regarding this topic, I will be entertaining this or that or those during the face-to-face classes. So please watch this video. I do hope that you're going to watch this, no, in the library individually or as a group, and then answer the written test. The deadline will be as follows. Babong trabaho, I know. You can complain, it's okay, but then again, you have to be professional. No, if you want to earn the grade, you have to comply. So thank you very much, dear students. Thank you and good morning. This is Sir Kim for CRPH Readings in Philippine History, signing off.